So today we will discuss Unit 2, that is assessment of learning, assessment for learning, assessment as learning. So these three concepts we will see in the today discussion. Can somebody say that what is assessment of learning? Because it's not a very new topic that you are learning. You must have learned so many times in the BEd, or you must have learned earlier also. Can somebody say that what is assessment of learning? Anybody?
सर, असेसमेंट मतलब असेसमेंट ऑफ लर्निंग में कितना पढ़ाया, मतलब टीचिंग लर्निंग प्रोसेस को असेस किया जाता है, मतलब कितना कुछ हुआ है या नहीं ये सब। और असेसमेंट फॉर लर्निंग में होता है कि उसको इम्प्रूव करने के लिए क्या क्या चेंजेस करना पड़ेगा, उसको पहले असेसमेंट करना पड़ता है, उसको बोलते हैं असेसमेंट फॉर लर्निंग।
अच्छा, असेसमेंट एज लर्निंग।
असेसमेंट एज लर्निंग मतलब लर्निंग के लिए भी असेसमेंट जरूरी होता है ना, तो
सो दैट इज असेसमेंट फॉर लर्निंग।
सॉरी सर, भूल गया हूँ शायद।
सब भूलते रहिए। उमाकांत, उमाकांत, आर यू हियर? संतोष जी, संतोष, आर यू गेटिंग मी? प्रियंका, प्रिया, व्हाट इज असेसमेंट ऑफ लर्निंग?
हेलो,
हाँ, बोलिए बोलिए।
असेसमेंट फॉर लर्निंग मतलब असेसमेंट फॉर लर्नर।
असेसमेंट फॉर लर्नर,
ओके। असेसमेंट एज लर्निंग मतलब असेसमेंट एज ए रिफ्लेक्टिव लर्नर।
असेसमेंट एज अ रिफ्लेक्टिव लर्नर, देन असेसमेंट एज लर्निंग। ठीक है, देर इज सो मच अननेसेसरी नॉइज।
जैसे हम सर, ये जो एक प्रोसेस है, जैसे हम बुकिंग करते हैं, एक रेसिपी बनाते हैं और उसमें हम नहीं पा रहे हैं।
रामेश्वरी, कैन यू से
यस सर, यस सर।
व्हाट इज असेसमेंट ऑफ लर्निंग, फॉर लर्निंग एंड असेसमेंट एज लर्निंग?
असेसमेंट, यस सर, यस सर। असेसमेंट फॉर लर्निंग मतलब टीचर जब स्टूडेंट को असेस करके स्टूडेंट का जो फॉल्ट और स्टूडेंट जो समझ नहीं पाते हैं, जैसे कि फॉर्मेटिव टाइप का एक असेसमेंट फॉर लर्निंग को बोलते हैं। टीचर का वीक का सर, स्टूडेंट का वीक कहाँ पर है और स्टूडेंट कहाँ पर स्ट्रेंथ है, फिर टीचर रिमेडियल दे सकते हैं। ये है असेसमेंट फॉर लर्निंग। एंड असेसमेंट ऑफ लर्निंग है, जैसे कि एक यूनिट और एक हाफ ईयरली टेस्ट को, हाफ ईयरली मतलब कोर्स को कंप्लीट करने के बाद फिर टीचर जो असेस करते हैं, इसको असेसमेंट ऑफ लर्निंग बोला जाता है। एंड असेसमेंट आज लर्निंग, जैसे कि सेल्फ असेसमेंट, मैं कितना जानती हूँ और कितना नहीं जानती हूँ और मुझे किस किस बुक फॉलो करना है, खुद को असेस करना, दैट इज असेसमेंट आज लर्निंग, जिसे ऐसे मैं समझती हूँ।
ओके, सो वन मोर रिस्पॉन्स वी विल टेक फ्रॉम दामोदर। यस दामोदर,
यस
कैन यू से व्हाट आर दोज थिंग्स?
सर, यस सर, आई विल ट्राई। असेसमेंट ऑफ लर्निंग इन द सेंस लाइक स्टूडेंट्स लेवल ऑफ अचीवमेंट वेयर वी कैन कंपेयर टू अदर स्टूडेंट्स। एंड लाइक एज लर्निंग मीन्स इट्स ओन लर्निंग, लाइक टू सेट एनी गोल और क्राइटेरिया एंड टू रीच देयर फॉर देयर ओन लर्निंग। which I think. And then last, assessment for learning in the sense where the learners are and where they need to go and how to do the best to reach the reach there, which I think.
Okay. Sir, may I?
Ha ha, Padmini, yes, please.
Sir, assessment for learning is kind of formative assessment, and assessment as learning is self-assessment, and assessment of learning is summative assessment.
Just wait 1 minute. हेलो हाँ नहीं नहीं बोलो ना कॉलेज में हाँ तो हम कहाँ भेजे थे कौन उसको बुला करके बोलो कौन भेजा नहीं। उसको फोन करो जो नंबर से फोन करके दिया है उसके ऊपर और क्या लिखा हुआ है डब्बा में डब्बा का फोटो भेजो ना क्लास ले रहे हैं हम 12:30 बजे कॉल करते हैं ओके सॉरी फॉर द डिस्टर्बेंस So thank you all those who have responded. When we see assessment is a process of appraising student performance. There we used to know about the student for creating better learning environment where the learner can learn in a better manner. But within that, there may be the different purpose of assessment. And based upon those purposes, we used to categorize the assessment process. The one kind of a situation may be we want to do assessment to know that what is the progress of a student, how much they have progressed out of your intervention, how much they have learned, so that you can get a feedback about their learning achievement. And this type of assessment we usually used to do at the end of a semester, at the end of a year, or at the end of a chapter. Here, the main motive of assessment is to know the achievement level of a student, how much they have achieved, how much they have progressed, how much they have developed, so that you can get a reflection and you can further decide that what kind of modification on the part of learning engagement is required. So this kind of assessment when we do to know the progress of a student, this is known as an assessment of learning, and it is a summative in nature. So summative assessments are known as an assessment of learning. Here the main purpose is to know their progress. Yes, of course, if it is an assessment, then we will also get a feedback. So getting feedback is a secondary one, but the primary one is I was talking about assessment of learning. Assessment of learning is a summative in nature. wherein we try to understand, we try to collect evidence of student's learning, student achievement, student development. And generally, this kind of assessment we used to do at the end of semester, at the end of year, or at the end of chapter, so that we can understand. Here I was also talking that getting feedback, since it is the assessment, so getting feedback is an inbuilt mechanism of assessment process. But getting feedback is a secondary in nature. The primary work is to know the progress of the student. On the other part, when we talk about assessment for learning, this kind of assessment is used to improve the learning situation, is to get a continuous feedback from the learner, and learner will also get a continuous feedback from the teacher's engagement, so that on a timely manner they can identify, they can know the learning difficulty that they are facing, and teacher as well as student can take a step to improve that. So here both will get a reflection, will get a feedback to improve the teaching learning process. Assessment for learning is formative in nature, and it happens at every moment of a time, very frequently. It is not like that we will do a paper pencil test for the assessment for learning. Assessment for learning can happen in a variety of ways, like when I am talking, like when I giving you to recite something, when you are doing a work. So every time we used to collect the measurable evidences to understand the level of progress and to understand the difficulty and also to understand the strength you are having. And the ultimate goal of understanding this thing is to make our teaching learning process more fruitful, more effective, more beneficial on the part of a teacher, on the part of a student. So here, this assessment we are not doing at the end. Rather than we are doing at every moment of a teaching learning process. It may be formal, it may be informal. It may be paper pencil test, it may be some alternate modality of testing, like a discussion, like a talk, like a portfolio, like assessing in a group work, like assessing in a collaborative and cooperative work. Even the peer assessment, self-assessment can also here work. Because here the purpose is to get a feedback. A student can also self-assess their progress for the teaching learning process. What kind of a difficulty they are having? What kind of a problem they are facing? What kind of a support they require from the teacher? What kind of a support teacher can provide for a better learning opportunity on the part of a student? So assessment for learning is a formative in nature, whereas assessment of learning is summative in nature. So this is the two concepts assessment for learning and assessment of learning. Here, one more thing it is important to mention that here not only we use to assess the curricular part, but we also use to assess the co-curricular part. Like that, their performance in the games, drama, music, literary activity, cultural activity, health and physical education, so that we can understand the learner holistically. Because we cannot segregate these things from the curricular part. These things help to excel in the curricular area. So understanding their health, understanding their mental stability, understanding their emotional balance is also important key aspect in the assessment process. So this is the concept. Then the next part comes assessment as learning. So till now we have seen that assessment for learning is a summative and the purpose is to provide a better opportunity. Assessment for learning is a kind of a formative when we talk about assessment as learning, it is a continuous process which happens during the learning process to continuously suit your strategy for betterment of a learner. For sake of example, you are going to teach, or better to say that you are teaching some content like that in geography, you are teaching about the longitude and the latitude. Or in the social science, okay, so I was saying that assessment as learning is a process where we continuously get feedback for improving the ongoing teaching learning process. And I was giving example, suppose that you are teaching longitude and a latitude in a geography class, say that class is standard 8. But before going to the class, you must have thought of some strategy. You must have planned some activities. You must have brought some learning aids. And you are engaging the learner in the learning activity. But as the assessment of learning or as the assessment for learning suggests, that we will get a reflection out of the teaching to improve the situation. But this is the situation where you cannot wait to get reflection when the class will get over. Because whatever you have planned, you are getting a reflection that your plan is not working. There is a requirement of modifying those plans. There is a requirement of adjusting those plans to suit the student requirement. Because when we talk about the teaching learning process, when we talk about dealing with the behavioral sciences, humans, we cannot be guaranteed that whatever you have planned, it will work 100% based upon the situation, based upon the student mental setup, based upon the emotional status. You are supposed to modify you are supposed to alter the predetermined, pre-planned strategy even during the taking the lesson, during delivering the lesson, during engaging the student in the learning process. So it is a very much required in some cases. So assessment as learning says that when you are engaging the learner in the learning situation, you must get continuous feedback to improve the learning situation. In some situation, a student can ask you for clarification. A student can ask some question to understand in a better manner. But some student, those who are introvert, some student, those who have a shyness, they are, have a feeling of a shy, they won't ask you question. So in those situation, teacher must identify them. It may be by asking some question, so that one portion of a content when you have covered, you can ask some question and you can get a feedback that to which level they have understood and what kind of things is required in order to make them understand in a better manner. It may be required that sometime you can see their gesture and a posture, their facial expression, to understand their degree of understanding out of your class, out of your intervention, out of the learning environment you have designed. Even when we talk about the assessment as learning and getting a feedback during the lesson, it also says that we must take care of the physical comfort of a learner. Suppose that the students are not feeling comfortable the way the sitting arrangement is done, and it may not be suiting the particular lesson that you are delivering. Like that, it may be required that you want to give some activity. For that, the special sitting arrangement is required. And since you have not asked, and students have not initiated by themselves, and they are sitting at their position and trying to learn, so it will be difficult for them. So the teacher must understand. Here, the clear-cut distinction is in the assessment of learning and in the assessment for learning, both were getting a reflection and they were taking initiation also to understand, to learn, to make a learning process better. But when we talk about assessment as learning, in the case assessment as learning, here the main initiation is to be done by the teacher. Teacher has to initiate to identify, to do some remedial activity, or to modify the activity, or even to use a different strategy of teaching. If the predetermined, pre-planned strategy is not well suited. Here we have also seen that in the assessment for learning and assessment as learning, which are summative and formative in nature respectively, that can be used for grading purpose also. Suppose that I am doing an assessment for learning or assessment as learning. The reflection that I am getting, that can be used for a grading purpose also. But in contrast to that, when we talk about assessment as learning, here we cannot use those reflections, those findings for grading purpose, because here purpose and situation both are entirely different. Here you have not to wait for class to end. Here you have not to wait for chapter to end. Here continuously you have to monitor, so that a better teaching learning environment can be made in the classroom. It happens as the teaching learning process is going on. And here you are modifying also as it is going on. In the formative and summative assessment of learning and assessment for learning, you have a time. But here you are supposed to do at that particular moment. You cannot wait to end the class, to finish the chapter. You have to do simultaneously when you are teaching. So assessment as learning is a process which happens as and when the classes are going on. And we are teaching, we are getting reflection, we are modifying, then again we are teaching, then we are getting, and then modifying. And it goes on till the moment we are satisfied. Okay, so this is the strategy that will work for this particular lesson, and that can be done. However, you may use this type of a feedback for the future classes also, when you will be taking the same content in the next year or the similar type of a content in the coming classes. You can use, there is no restriction, means you can use it as a formative that may be depending upon the situation. But the primary function of assessment as learning is to provide support and assistance at a time. That is the assessment as learning. Okay, so I think now it is a time to take some questions. If you have any kind of a question, you can ask me now.
Hello, sir.
Yes, please. Please.
Sir, assessment आपने बताया कि curriculum में क्यों add हुआ है, और एक बार थोड़ा बता दीजिए. क्या? Curriculum में ये assessment. Hello.
Yes.
सर, ये जो असेसमेंट है ये तो हमने पहले से भी पढ़ा है, जो पढ़ा है यहाँ भी वही है, लेकिन करिकुलम के साथ इससे क्या रिलेशन है, करिकुलम में क्यों ये है?
अच्छा, योर प्लीज म्यूट योर सेल्फ. ओके, सो योर क्वेश्चन इज रिलेटेड टू द सिलेबस दैट यू हैव स्टडीड ऑल दोस थिंग्स अर्लियर. So why it was necessary to add it again in the curriculum paper? Okay, the question is very right and very insightful, that we have studied, and so why we are required to study it again. The one thing which I think that why it is necessary, because most of you, when I ask the question, you don't reply. So that may be one of the reason. They may be thinking that want to be able to reply. Okay, or Suryakant is saying that to recall. No, recalling is not a major objective of that. Objective is a different, I will tell. And that I have told it was just for a joke. For Suryakant, that if it is required to recall, na, so when we talk about the objectives, there are two type of objective. One thing is a intentional objective. Another one is the incidental objective. So in the intentional objective, we used to include the content as per the objective that are supposed to taught intentionally, purposefully, that you are supposed to know, that's why it is incorporated. But for incidental objective, na, content are not being prescribed in syllabus. यू विल लर्न व्हेन द इंसिडेंटल ऑब्जेक्टिव्स आर बीइंग फुलफिल्ड मींस द कंटेंट रिलेटेड टू द इंसिडेंटल ऑब्जेक्टिव आर बीइंग टॉट सो रिकॉलिंग कैन हैपन एट दैट टाइम फर्स्ट टाइम अबाउट द असेसमेंट दिस थ्री टाइप ऑफ असेसमेंट यू हैव लर्नड ऑलरेडी इन द बीएड सो यू कैन रिकॉल दोज थिंग्स टू when you will be going through the incidental objectives and the content related to them. But the main focus of including these things in the curriculum paper is, first thing is that you must develop a clear-cut competency in those area so that when you will develop a curriculum, so you will have a clear-cut understanding about these things and you will incorporate that in the curriculum. Because curriculum includes everything. Curriculum is not a merely a collection of a content. When we talk about the curriculum, it includes curricular area, co-curricular area. It includes the assessment strategy also. It includes the objective of a lesson also, isn't it? Even the transactional modality is also prescribed. So curriculum is defined in that way. It have all the things. This is the one correlation. But more important significance of including this is that assessment and evaluation is not a thing that we only do when we take class. I think when you will remember, when I was discussing about the assessment and evaluation, I have told you that assessment is a process of appraising, assessment is a process of appraising process, any kind of a work, any kind of a process. It is a phenomena to appraise the process. It is a phenomena to evaluate the process, if it is an evaluation. So evaluation and assessment are done in every aspect of the life. And similarly, when the point of curriculum development and modification comes, that time also we used to do an assessment and evaluation. Assessment and evaluation will not happen at the end of 5 years. Continuously, you have to get a feedback. Student feedback as well as the teacher feedback, means those who are implementing and on which it is implemented to make a better curriculum as per the need and demand. So getting a continuous feedback is a one of the important key aspect in development of a curriculum. However, in practice, that the general practice which we have in India or particularly in our university, we are not modifying curriculum at every year, at every 1 year interval of a time. But it should be modified as per the need and demand of the learner, of the context, the situation. Like that, when we talk about this situation, this pandemic has taught us to develop the competency for handling online classes. That should get an important part in the teacher preparation program. So, if that kind of autonomy is there, we could have modified that. But our system is not that much flexible. We are little bit rigid in nature. And that's why the assessment and evaluation and different type of assessment and evaluation is incorporated in the syllabus. So that you can make a link with the curriculum development process and the curriculum appraisal, assessment and evaluation process. So first we are going with the assessment and evaluation. In the coming units, we will see the modality of development and appraising curriculum, and the latter part, that is at the end of this paper, we will see that how these three things are interrelated, correlated and important. So assessment and evaluation we used to do in every aspect, everywhere. That's why this is incorporated in a syllabus. Yes, Priyanka, I think.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Any other question?
हेलो सर.
हाँ तनुष प्लीज.
सर आपने बताया जैसे असेसमेंट फॉर लर्निंग इज ए फॉर्मेटिव नेचर एंड असेसमेंट ऑफ लर्निंग इज ए समेटिव नेचर, देन जो असेसमेंट आज लर्निंग को हम फॉर्मेटिव में रख सकते हैं?
नो, इट इज नॉट अ फॉर्मेटिव बिकॉज वी आर नॉट गेटिंग फीडबैक एट द एंड. इट इज अ कंटिन्यूअस, है ना. आई एम अ टीचिंग, I am getting reflection, again I am teaching, so it's going on. And when we talk about the assessment as learning, na, actually not abhi learning ko chhod dijiye, when we talk assessment as, so actually it is an inbuilt mechanism of every process. Suppose that when you have asked the question, okay, so you have framed the question and you spoke to me, but you will feel that whatever you are speaking, it is not making a clear cut understanding to me, so that I can respond back to your question. So again you will supplement the sentence. Okay, so what is happening here? You have already presented your question, but you got a feedback that it is not presented in the appropriate manner so that I can understand that. Then you have supplemented that, you have modified that, you have rectified that. So assessment as process is actually the inbuilt mechanism of everything. Whatever we used to do, we used to get a reflection and we don't wait to get it over so that you will start afresh. No, we don't wait. We immediately rectify that. So it's a kind of an ongoing process, which is the inbuilt mechanism. So it will not fall under the formative or assumptive. However, you can use that, like that I was saying, you can use the finding, the reflection or a feedback for the formative assessment. Like that I was saying, when you will take the same class next year, next time, next batch of the student, or a reteaching, or the similar content you are teaching. So you can use a feedback as formative assessment, as formative feedback. But the primary function is not that. You are taking advantage is a different kind of a thing. But the primary is that when the things are going on, when the process is going on, then immediately you should do it. Okay. Is it clear to you, Tanuj?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So, any other question? Santosh is messaging something. Self-assessment and NEP 2020 is an innovative innovation in CBSE schooling state government. Self-assessment is when we talk about the assessment as learning, it is a kind of a self-assessment. Even when we talk about the assessment for learning also, assessment of learning also, it also includes a self-assessment. Suppose that when you are a teaching, so students are getting reflection. How they are getting? By the self-assessment, or you may ask questions so they can realize. And how the teacher is getting reflection? By the self-assessment. So self-assessment happens in all the three types of assessment. Okay, it was existing well. Okay, so I think it is already 12:20, and we can stop the session here. Shall we stop?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so thank you for being with me. Have a nice day.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.